All right, here is another interesting point. All right, so wired up incorporated imports electrical conductors from Mexico. And you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to, since we're going to be using those formulas, I'm going to rewrite this a little bit. So to create more space on the board. So net cost would be RVC equals NC minus VNM, value of non-originating material, divided by NC times 100. And transaction value would be RVC equals transaction value minus value of non-originating materials divided by transaction value times 100. Okay, this way I created much more space because we're going to need this. All right, so we have the following. Wired up imports electrical conductors from Mexico. So we have electrical conductors. The relationship influences the sale price. All right, so because the relationship influences the sale price, transaction value is not for us. Our guy is the net cost guy. So that's the thing to keep in mind. The production process uses a copper wire from Japan. So we have copper wire. It's made in Japan. And other materials are used of US origin, so it's NAFTA country, right? The net cost of the materials of the electrical conductors is $56 per unit. In order for electrical conductors to qualify for NAFTA preferential duty treatment under GNB2, so that's origination, the value of copper wire used per electrical conductor must not be greater than, so copper wire is Japan, right? So this is X because it's an unknown. And which of the following correctly fills in the blank? All right, so this is interesting because what customs examiners are asking us to do is do kind of like a reverse calculation. Instead of giving you all the numbers to plug into the formula, they're giving you only the partials and some of them on the other side. All right. So first thing we need to notice is the rules. All right. So what we need to establish in here is we need to establish the electrical conductors. So what we do is we go to the alphabetical index. And we scroll through to the electrical conductors. And for the sake of time, I'm just going to go straight into that page. All right, so we're not worrying about electrical because conductors here is a noun. Right here, conductors. Conductors are classified under HTS US, and here we have the following options: 85, 44, 11, point 11, subheading 11 through subheading 60. All right. Then we have a copper wire, and copper wire is provided under. So we have copper wire. Again, I'm using alphabetical index for the ease of reference. I know this is not legally binding, because customs examiners also ask you about the legally binding part, but for the heat of the examination, this will do for now. So here, copper wire will be classified under 74, 08, 11, 19. All right, what's the next step? So the next step, since the is the focus of where the substantial transformation takes place, because the way the non-originating materials must be transformed in the NAFTA country, right? So the substantial transformation takes place because in Mexico, and it takes place in the form of electrical conductors. So our focus would be general node rules 4, chapter 85. So the next step is we go to the rule for the chapter 85. So we're gonna go to general node, and we're gonna look up that rule again. I'll be using the shortcut. And here we see the paragraph 147. We have 85-44 subheading 11 through 60, which is this one. And paragraph A says a change to subheading, which is given to us from any subheading outside that group, except from heading 7804. And heading 7804 is precisely description of the copper wire. So for us, paragraph A would be problematic, right? But we are not done yet, because we have or provision, because 7804 acts as a disqualifier. We go to the B, and we have the following statement on the B: a change to subheading 85-44-11 through 85-44-60 from headings 7408, which is our guy, whether or not there is also a change from any other subheading, including that subheading, provided that the RVC, so here RVC, is not less than, so meaning that it must be equals or more, and we customs examiners have told us that the relationship influences the price, so we cannot use transaction value, so we must go to the net cost. So subparagraph 1 is not our choice, because it deals with transaction. We're going to the 50% rule, which is a net cost method. So RVC must be 50%. All right, so sounds like we got our variables to do the calculation. So let's go back to that exam question, and we're looking for the right answer choice over here. So how do we do this? So we know the original value constant, which is 50, and we know that it equals to the net cost, and we know the net cost is 56. And what we're looking for is a value of non-originating material, right? Because this is value of non-originating material, right? So let's call it VNM. It must be divided by another net cost, which is, as customs examiners have told us, also 56. And we have to multiply it by 100. And the reason to do that is because this is expressed in the percentage points. All right, so we got our stuff. Now we need to do some mathematics. So here what we do is we just start the arithmetic, right? So 56 minus VNM. Here we can divide 100 by 56, which will be 0.56, right? Then we take 0.56 and we bring it over here. So the 0.56 times 50 equals 56 minus VNM. All right. So now, this is where the calculator gets handy, unless you're really good at math. You go 0.56 times 50. And 0.56 times 50, it will be 28 equals 56 minus VNM, value of non-originating material. Now you bring this over to the other side, so this would be 28 minus 56 equals negative VNM. And 28 minus 56 is 28. So for that, we would need a calculator, hopefully. So it will be minus 28 equals minus VNM. And we multiply this by negative 1. We apply this to here, and we apply this to here. And VNM, we get the value for VNM M equals 28. So this would be the final answer. VNM equals 28. All right. So that's the mathematical part. Now let's go to the answer choices. 28 jumps right out. So I do not know about those. Those are probably misleading. The value of the copper wire is irrelevant because the copper wire makes the necessary tariff shift. No, we saw in the general note 12 that it is not irrelevant because tariff shift is not enough. Here, under A, it would be enough, but that copper wire classification is a prerequisite. So you have to classify this one, you have to classify this one, at least to the heading level, so you know what to eliminate, what's not. Then you need to know the which formula to use. The customer designer tells that there is a relationship, so net cost is applicable. Then you take the formula, you take the numbers, you plug it in, and you do the math to get to 28. So obviously this may take longer than the general average of the exam to time to complete, but some of the questions are easier than others, so you save some, you lose some, right? This is the way it goes, so keep that in mind. All right, so that's for our wired up ink. Correct answer received must not be greater than $28.